Hi, so today I'm going to be reading The Liberation of Gabriel King, Chapter 9. This is called Watergate and Peanut Farmers. If you don't know anything about Watergate, it was a scandal in the 1970s that led to Nixon resigning from office. Watergate and Peanut Farmers. Frieda said faith was believing in what you could not see and pressing on until you could see it. Well, I wasn't going to be pressing nowhere with any spider. In fact, I wasn't going to so much as look at that spider again, no matter what Frieda had planned. I wasn't going to make him my pet, because if you remember yesterday, they got a spider, and she said he had to name it so he wouldn't be scared of it. I wasn't going to name him, make him my pet, or anything, and I sure as heck wasn't going to overcome any more fears. I was sure of it. At least I was sure of it until Jimmy Carter got in the way. Jimmy Carter would be someone that would run for president. He came up on account of me having to take a bath before dinner because I smelled like swamp monk. My taking a bath meant Pop turned on the news soon as he got home because I wasn't ready for dinner yet. Most days, Pop and the news didn't mix because soon as he turned on the TV, he got all riled up. Sometimes it was at the cost of gasoline that got under his skin or them talking about what happened in Vietnam, but most of the time, it was the election. When I got out of the bath, I could hear Walter Cronkite, the anchorman, reading the news, and by the time I put on my pajamas and climbed on the couch, Pop was scowling something fierce. "What's happening, Pop?" I asked, curling up next to him. Pop was still in his work clothes, so he smelled like peanuts and fertilizer. I'm going to take a second. I think that Walter Cronkite guy is real, but I'm just going to look. I feel like I've heard his name. Yes, Walter Cronkite. He was a famous broadcast journalist for CBS News. And he was often cited as the most trusted man in America. Okay, he died in 2009. But anyways, here we go. "What's happening, Pop?" I asked, curling up next to him. Pop was still in his work clothes, so he smelled like peanuts and fertilizer. "Darn election," he said. "Jimmy Carter's not doing so good. General Ford moved ahead in the polls. You think people would want to change after everything we've been going through?" I shrugged. "Maybe they want things to stay the same," I said, but Pop gave me a look. "Things can't stay the same forever," he told me. "Some things you've got to fight to make sure things do change." Mama hollered from the kitchen. "Alan," she said to Pop, "don't get started. Gabe doesn't want to hear about politics." But Mama was wrong. I did want to hear about politics. "How come you don't like General Ford?" I asked. "Because he's not from Georgia?" "No," Pop said. He got up and turned off the TV. "You know what happened with Watergate? I shook my head. "I sort of knew, but not exactly. Watergate," said Pop, "was the reason President Nixon had to resign. You see, the Nixon White House wasn't very honest from the beginning. First, the vice president had to quit because he did something sneaky with his taxes. Then the president, Nixon, had to resign because he was caught ordering people to spy on Democratic Party at the Watergate Hotel." "Wow," I said. "I thought spying was pretty cool," but Pop shook his head. "Spying is never a good thing," he said, "but it's especially bad when the president does it." Kind of ironic because we know that's what Trump was trying to do. Kind of try to find out some things about the Bidens. So interesting timing of reading this. "He was going to use the information to hurt the Democratic campaign. And if he did that, how would people make good decisions about voting? Elections are supposed to be fair, and if they're not, then we're no different from any other country. The president is supposed to understand that." Pause. "You know what's worse?" he asked. "After everyone found out what he'd done, President Nixon still lied about the whole thing. Only they caught him on tape." "Really?" I asked. "Did he get in trouble?" I figured he went to jail, but Pop shook his head. "No," he said. "What happened to him?" "Well, the guy who took over as president, he promised everyone he wasn't going to do anything sneaky. Only right away, he let Mr. Nixon off the hook for everything. That's called a pardon." Pop leaned in. "You know who that man was?" "Nope." "The man was General Ford." My eyes bugged out of my head. "The same General Ford who's running against Jimmy Carter?" "Yep," said Pop. He raised his eyebrows. "Still thinking things should stay the same?" "Sure was a lot more complicated than I thought. Besides," Pop told me, settling back on the couch, "even if Watergate hadn't happened, I'd still be voting for Carter. He's one of us. Used to be a peanut farmer. Did you know that?" "I sure didn't." "You mean a peanut farmer can run for president?" Pop nodded. Then he looked at me real steady. "You want to hear a story about Jimmy Carter?" He asked, I always wanted to hear a story when Pop was telling, so I leaned in close and breathed in the smell of the peanuts. Well, said Pop, when Jimmy Carter was living in Plains, which is a town just about like Hallowell, he ran a peanut warehouse. This was before you were born, and lots of stuff was changing between black folks and white folks. Some people weren't too happy about that. They wanted everything to stay the same. Pop poked me in the stomach. Some of the men in the South started a group called the White Citizens Council. The whole purpose of the group was to keep up the laws that kept black and white people separate. Segregation, I asked. That was a word I heard Freddie use plenty of times. That's right, said Pop. They wanted to keep up segregation. So you know what they did? They tried to get every white man in Plains to join that council. They were bullies like that kid at school. Like Duke, I said, sitting up. That's right, said Pop. They wanted to bully Jimmy Carter into signing up for their group. They said if he didn't, they wouldn't buy from his warehouse anymore and his store would go out of business. What'd he do? I asked, leaning forward. Did he have to join up? Did he have to move to another state? Pop shook his head. No, sir, he said. He was the only white man in Plains not to join. I sat back against the couch. Huh, I bet that took some courage. You know why he stood his ground, Pop asked? I shook my head. Because he had something he didn't want them to take from him. Integrity, Pop said. Stood up and ruffled my hair. Maybe you'll run for president someday, he said with a wink, if you make it through the fifth grade. Pop went into the kitchen and I sat on the couch thinking, I sure could use some courage. And now that Pop mentioned it, maybe I could use some integrity too. Maybe it wouldn't kill me to give Frida's plan one teeny tiny try. And I'm going to look up the definition of integrity. I know what it means. I just want to have a definition that makes it understandable for you. So integrity is the quality of being honest and having strong morals, principles, or moral rightness. So the state of being whole or divided. So if you have integrity, you usually do the right thing and stick up for what you believe in. So that was chapter 9. Bye.